Welcome to Precise Mathematics Academy. In previous lecture, we have seen the examples of particular integral of type number 4, that is e(x)to(m), that is x is polynomial x. Now today we will see the another example, which is of type number 5 or case number 5. Solve d square plus 2d plus 2 into y is equal to e raised to 2x into sine of 2x. Now we have to solve this example. Here this example is of type number 5. Now first to find CF. So auxiliary equation is d square plus 2d plus 2, that is equal to 0. So here we have to find two factors, whose multiplication is 2 and addition is 2. So there are no two factors whose multiplication is 2 and addition is 2. So therefore we have to use the formula again. So d is equal to minus d plus or minus under root d square minus 4ac upon 2. Here a is equal to 1, b is equal to 2, and c is equal to also 2. So now d is equal to, if you put this value here, what we get? Minus 2 plus or minus under root 4 minus 4 into a is 1 and c is 2 divided by 2 into 1, that is equal to minus 2 plus or minus under root 4 minus 8 divided by, that is equal to minus 2 plus or minus under root, it will be minus 4 divided by 2, that is equal to minus 2 plus or minus, here under root 2, under root minus is there, that's why the square root of 4 is 2, and for this minus sign we can write I divided by 2. So if you take common 2 common and cancel with this 2, so what we get? Minus 1 plus or minus I. So this is value of D. Now roots are imaginary and different, and that's why the complementary function is given by CF is equal to e raised to minus x in bracket c1 cos of x plus c2 sin of x. So this is your CF. Now second step, to find pi. Now we know that pi is equal to 1 upon f of t into f of x. This is the general formula to calculate pi. So therefore pi is equal to 1 upon d square plus 2d plus 2, this is f of a given, and f of x is here e raised to 2x into sine of 2x. Now whenever there is a combination of two cases, that is e raised to 2x is the case number 1 and sine 2x is the case number 3, whenever this situation occurs, then what you have to do? We have to take e raised to 2x common first. Now we have to take this e raised to 2x outside this bracket. Now how to take this? How to do this? So for that, you have to put d is equal to d plus 2. That means here the coefficient of x is 2. So here we have to write down d is equal to d plus 2. And after putting this, what we get? E raised to 2x we can write down here. 1 upon in place of d, we have to write down this. So d plus 2 bracket square plus 2 into d plus 2 plus 2 into sine of 2x will be like this here on the right. So that is equal to e raised to 2x, and it is 1 upon, simplify this. So after simplifying this, what we get? D square plus 4d plus 4 plus 2d plus 4 plus 2 into sine of 2x. This can be written as e raised to 2x 1 upon d square plus this 4d and this 2d will be 6d plus 4 plus 4 8, 8 plus 2 is 10 into sine of 2x. Now this is case number 3. We have already simplified such type of examples. So what we have to do? Put d square is equal to minus 2 square, that is minus 4. So that is equal to e raised to 2x in bracket 1 upon, in place of this square we have to write minus 4, so therefore minus 4 plus 6d plus 10 into sin of 2x. Now if we further simplify this, a raised to 2x 1 upon, write on the 60 first, so 60, 10 minus 4 will be plus 6, 10 minus 4 will be 6 into sin of 2x. Now after that, here at the denominator we can take 6 common, so this can be written as, if you take 6 common from denominator, what we get? This is equal to e raised to 2x divided by 6 in bracket, what we get? 1 upon d plus 1 into sin of 2x. Now here at the denominator there is only t, there is no d square, and here is sin 2x, so therefore what we have to do? We have to do the rationalization. So by the rationalization, what we can write? E raised to 2x upon 6 it is in bracket 1 upon d plus 1 into d minus 1 t minus 1 into sin of 2x bracket plus. This can be written as e raised to 2x upon 6 it is. Here d minus 1 will be it is a plus b a minus b. So by using this a square minus b square formula, this will be a square minus 1 into sin of 2x. Now here there is a d square available, so we can now put d square equal to minus 2 square, that is minus 4. If you put this value here, what do we get? E raised to 2x divided by 6 in bracket d minus 1 divided by minus 4 minus 1 into sin of 2x. And finally, e raised to 2x divided by 6 in bracket. Now we can multiply by this sin 2x to this bracket. So here derivative of sin 2x minus 1 into sin 2x, that is sin 2x divided by minus 5 bracket plus. This can be written as e raised to 2x divided by 6 in bracket. Derivative of sin 2x is cos of 2x into 2. So that is 2 minus sin of 2x divided by 5. So this is clear. Now next, we can simplify this further. PR is equal to e raised to 2x upon 6. We can multiply this to this by this to this bracket. What we get here? So 2 divided by 6, that will be 3. So here e raised to 2x into cos of 2x divided by 3 into 5, that will be 15, minus e raised to 2x into sin of 2x divided by 50. E raised to 2x upon 6. Okay, now that is equal to, so this is value of pi, and finally complete solution is y is equal to cm plus pi. And that is equal to y is equal to cf is e raised to minus x in bracket c1 cos x plus c2 sin x plus pi is e raised to 2x into cos of 2x upon 15 minus e raised to 2x into sin of 2x divided by 15. This is your complete solution. Thank you very much.